accomplishments in high school and in the athletic world. And this is a really great time for us. This is our sixth signing. We do the first one in February, then we do another one here in May. This is so exciting. The biggest people to thank, athletes, are your parents sitting right here. So you need to give them a round of applause. And why is that? How many parents, you can raise your hand if you brought anybody to practice at age 3 that they started doing their sport, at age 4, at age 5, at 5 o'clock in the morning practices, at 6 o'clock at night practices, running them from game to this game to that game to all that. And then you get to high school, and then we go from game to game and event to event. So without the parents' support, none of this would be taking place right now. So you guys are huge, huge to where they are. And now it's all up to them, right? From this point on, now they go on to college, and they're everything from that point on. So we're celebrating today how this looks. We will have the coach come up with the athletes, and it's by sport, so we do all the sports, all the same like sports together. Coach talks about them. Mom and Dad, if you want to sit up with them, stand behind them. We'll fit everybody behind the table as much as we can. Then they do their ceremonial signing. We'll give them a round of applause, and then we work on to the next group. Okay, so it's a great time. Photo ops at the end, then we'll have all the athletes together around the table, and they'll take a picture there also. First up, we go to women's basketball with Coach Morley. And BB Gist, come on up.
Seniors are signing today, so it's a neat experience for our senior girls, but in particular for BB. BB has had a great career with us here at Liberty North. So far this season, she's been averaging 14 points and about 8 rebounds a game. She's close to setting a number of records. She has, right now she's at 241 points, which puts her about 80 points away from setting a single season record for the most amount of points in a season. She's the second in career points scored, so 28 is the, highest points scored in a game. So 28 is the highest. She had 27 the other night against Park Hill South. So she was 1 point away from setting the record there. She's fourth in North history for career rebounds at 326. She's 15 rebounds away from setting the single season rebounding record. And she's sixth right now as of today in career field goals. So she's probably, I would guess, by the end of season, going to clear out the record books a little bit and set some pretty neat records. So overall, she's had a great career. Unfortunately, last year ended a little short with a broken ankle. And so she's had to fight through a little bit of adversity with that. And eighth grade, she tore ACL. So she's kind of had a tough road here. But she's persevered and had a great season here. And so much so that Johnson County, who's one of the best JUCOs in the country, have won many national championships, sought her out, and have decided that they want to take her there and have her continue her career. So Evie's going to sign her letter of intent tonight, and we're grateful to have her as an Eagle.
How about one more round of applause for BB Gist? Next up is girls track and cross country. track and cross country. Coach Chatlos will introduce both these young ladies. Coach Chatlos.
Thank you. I get the honor of introducing two young ladies who are signing today. And if you look really, really carefully, you'll see both their names up on those record boards up there. So it's been quite an honor to get to work with both these young ladies and their families as well. I'm going to start, since cross country is more recent, I'm going to start with Kelsey Cox. Kelsey has she's a four-year letter winner for us with cross country. And, you know, I like to focus on... Hello? I'll make it kind of short, but I like to focus on one thing they've done in it. And I'd like to point out for Kelsey that she is probably the best leader that we've ever had, boy or girl, on our cross-country team. Been able to... Oh, thank you. She was thrust in that position last year when we didn't have many seniors on varsity, and she was the top returner, and she really took the bull by the horns and made sure the girls were doing everything correctly and doing it at the right time and doing what they were supposed to do. And she was never afraid to make sure somebody who was messing around knew that they were messing around and knew they shouldn't be doing it. And it's pretty rare for any high schooler, but especially a high school girl. That was, it's been really impressive. She also happens to be pretty fast. So she's the number three girl all time. If you look up there on the cross country board for cross country, number three. She's also been part of two conference titles in cross country, one conference title in track. She was part of a district title in cross country, 4-year all conference winner in cross country, 2-year all district winner in cross country, and 2-time all stater in cross country. As far as track, she's been all state 1 year. And the 4x8, and that was also a school record, which you can see up there. She's a sectional qualifier in 3 years, and a school record holder in the 4x8 as well. 6 times all conference, a lot of accolades here, and 2-time conference championship in the 4x8. So Kelsey Cox is going to be signing to go to Mo West. Right? And then on the track side of things, we have Jennifer LeHue. We've had a pretty good track program over the years, but I don't think many people would argue with me when I say that she is the best overall athlete that we've had. She can do anything from walking on her hands across the gym floor to she could probably long jump about as well as anyone, or triple jump, or it turns out she's an incredible sprinter, and she was on our sprint team that has the school record. Her name's up there for 4x1, 4x100 meters. But really her big event is the pole vault. And she started with us as a freshman. She set the record 3 meets in, and she's held it ever since. She has steadily increased her PR by 1.5 feet every year, which is really amazing to do, including some of her accolades are all conference 3 times so far. Remember, she's only had 3 opportunities. She's only a junior. She was a district champion and runner-up twice. And get this, in the last 3 years, she's been either the champion or runner-up 19 times in some meet that she's participated. 19 out of, well, not many more than that. It's an incredible record and one that may never be broken. She's also had, let's see, that's 6 meet championships and 11 runners up. And she's going to be signing to go to Northwest Missouri State.
One more round of applause to these two young ladies. Congratulations, girls. Next up, we'll have our football signees. So football players, come on up.
Individually about each one, or we would be here for a very long time because there's a lot of good things to be said about these young men. Just suffice it to say that at that table there's sitting a total of 12 all-conference awards, an all-state award, a conference championship football team, a district championship football team, and many hours of work have been put in to create that, and each of these young men is extremely deserving of their scholarship opportunity. Tarion will be going to Southeast Missouri State. Armand Baker will be going to Missouri State. They won't be too far away from each other, so it'll be okay, guys. You can make the drive. All right, Drew Geiser will be going to Simpson. Kenton Brandenberry will be going to St. Mary. And Michael Neisser will be going to Truman State. Each of these young men have done great work, both on the playing field and in the classroom. They have a whole lot to be proud of, and dads, I know you guys are proud, and you've deserved any success that they have.
One more round of applause for these young men. Congratulations, fellas. Next up is women's soccer. Introducing women's soccer's head coach, Steve Person.
Test. This is my favorite part of my job. When we get to have athletes come down here and move on to the next their career, it's a little bit odd in that we haven't had of their story written here at Liberty North yet because we're a spring sport. So keep in mind the statistics that I'm going to fire off really quickly only encompass 3 years within the program. Both of these young ladies have been integral parts of the rise of our program from kind of a middle of the pack team to winning two straight conference titles and challenging for district titles, and we hope to enjoy the same success this year. As a in 50 career wins that these two young ladies have led their team to. And I'm going to start with the individual statistics with Katie. Katie burst on the scene in 2014, earning first team all conference and all district and first team honors and second team all conference honors, and followed 2016 with all conference honorable mention. She has 41 career goals in three seasons and 15 assists, and that ranks her current team career goal scoring leader. So that is a tremendous honor for her. She will be signing today for Southeast Missouri State, and she becomes our first Division I athlete from our program. So congratulations, Katie. Go Red Hawks. Bree is our second signee today. Her individual statistics, in addition to being an instrumental part, really the heartbeat of the 3 years that she has led this team. 2014 first team all district, second team all conference. 2015 first team all conference, second team all district. 2016 first team all district and first team all conference. She really embodies the leadership traits that we look for. She is the metronome. She sets the pace for what we do on the field. She is a tremendous leader in the classroom and in our school, and she will be signing today with Northwest Missouri State.
Give it up. Next up is softball, and Coach Brett Kisker will introduce our softball signee.
So I only have one player to talk about. I'm going to talk about her for the next 45 minutes. I hope you guys are okay with that. We have Destiny Ojigo here, who's been a huge part of our team for the last 4 years. This season especially put up some very, very strong stats and helped us to have a lot of success. She had 452 at the plate, which is pretty unbelievable. Had an OPS over 1,000, had 26 RBIs and 27 runs. And considering that I had a courtesy runner for her as a pitcher, that means that not all the runs that she actually could have scored got counted. Other girls got those stats. She threw about half the innings, a little under half, and went 10-3 and on the mound for us with the 2.86 ERA. But I think that all of that, she would say, probably didn't matter at all, because the highlight of the season was beating Staley to go to the state quarterfinals this year. So she did well enough that she was recognized as an all-region pitcher this year, which means that she's one of the top players in the entire Kansas City metro area. I mean, that's saying a lot to be named as an all-region player. Over her career, she was 22-5 as a pitcher. She was part of a team that went 92-27 in her 4 years here, and a large part of that is because of her and the success that she had and her work ethic. We had three conference championships while she was here, three district championships, two state quarterfinal appearances, and she's also a three-time academic All-State player, which means that up here she's got it going on as well. The work ethic extends to the classroom, and I think that that's a lesson younger players, you guys need to be taking into account, that it's actually kind of important to do well in class as well. Let's see, other things. She was named as a 2016 All-Region pitcher. She was a two-time All-District player and a three-time All-Conference player. I think the big things, though, honestly, if what I'm going to remember about Destiny is just the intangibles. The smile that she comes to practice with every day is infectious. And she's just got a great attitude, and the other girls want to be around her. She's got unbelievable work ethic. I see her in the weight room all the time working out. I know she's exercising. She's practicing to play multiple sports, which is a big deal. It's really hard to get girls to not specialize in softball. I'm sure that goes that way for every sport. You know, it's important that you guys are using different muscles throughout the year. And I know that the experience that she had in other sports really helped her with softball. And she's a student of the game. She's always wanting to learn. She's always getting better. She works hard on the field. She works hard off the field. She works hard in the classroom. And all of that has culminated in her getting paid a little bit of money to go play softball at Emporia State, where she's going to have a ton of success. Congratulations, Destiny.
I'd like to start with just a couple of accomplishments, or several accomplishments that Mitchell's had here at Liberty North on the swim team. Mitchell's been first team all conference all 4 years. He's been a state qualifier all 4 years. He was all state honorable mention his sophomore year and first team all state both his junior and senior year. He has a couple of records.
He's also been on the relay team that has all, we have three relays, and he's been a member of each of those records as well. Just the class records, his name is littered through that as well. And he's just been one of our best all-around swimmers the last 4 years. But despite all that, when I think of Mitchell, I think of Mitchell as being someone who's always been a team first person. The performance that every member of our team has is as important to him as it was of his own performances, and he's really carried that, and that's been something that's really defined him and how he's approached our team over the last 4 years. Mitchell's also a tremendous student. Academics are important. He's always excelled at that, and I know he's going to excel at that over the next 4 years. So today he'll be signing with Grinnell College.
One more round of applause. Congratulations, Mitch. After we're finished, athletes, make sure you're going to come around the table and get a photo op taken care of. But what everybody remembers and what everybody you move from being an Eagle to your next school, remember, you're always an Eagle. Whether you're Storm, Cavalier, Hornet, Griffin, Bearcat, Bear, Spire, Pioneer, or Bulldog, or even a Red Hawk, and we got a couple, you're always an Eagle. Don't forget it. Thank you for everything you've done for Liberty North. You set the bar high. Congratulations. Celebrate your day. Come get a picture here. Thank you all for coming. Have a great day. Yeah.